ज्ञान जन शलाकय चक्षुर्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासुन्दरैव च भक्तानां कामनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महापतन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदाय नाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नम्ने गौरविदे गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालयै कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय सदभक्ताय भक्त्या विहीना शरणं प्रपन्ना वृंदे नमस्ते चरणारविंदं प्रव्रजन्तं प्रीतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकाकरयाजुमान् पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोऽभिनेदु
offering my less and less dhanvat pranam unto the lotus of feet of my Gurudev, Srila Prishna Vishnu Bhad, Ishmar Bhakti Pradhyam, Kishore Swami Maharaj. Also I am offering my dhanvat pranam in the lotus of feet of my Shiksha Guru, who preached the mission to the whole world in a very little time. I see that anyhow all the devotees, by his mercy, reading his books, are being associated with him, disciples. They have come to this land, Bhakti land. Everywhere in here. He was really a guru. And by his mercy, we can know Radha and Krishna, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and his teachings. But nowadays, in Vrindavan mission, that some Babaji are there, and they are telling that Swamiji or the disciples of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, really they had no any Guru Parampara. The foolish persons, very weak persons, not knowing any Shastra, they may be bewildered by these things. But if a man who can preach the mission of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in the whole world in a very little time, he can write so many books like Patanjali books like Chaitanya Charitamrita. He can publish and explain Srimad Bhagavatam देखो शापरूप गोस्वामी जीव गोस्वामी हाउ वी कैन बी ऑर्डिनरी पर्सन इवन इन द लाइन ऑफ श्रील भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर श्रील प्रभुपाद इन द लाइन ऑफ रियली रघुनाथ दास गोस्वामी रूप गोस्वामी सर्व दामोदर राय रामानंद एंड श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु Babaji are envious. I don't know from where they can. Where is their Guru Parampara? Actually, there is no Guru Parampara of all these Babaji, so called Babaji. That is why they are doing some nonsense things to real Vaishnavas and Guru Parampara. I see that in any epic, Bhagavad, Gita, any Puran, even in Upanishads, in Vedanta, in Baldev Vidyabhushan Govinda Bhashya, or in the books of Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, Narottam Thakur, there is no word Babaji. Never I have seen. You cannot see. Babaji word. From where this came? But, on the other hand, we see renounce order, sannyas. It is written in Vedas, Srimad Bhagavatam, Tridanda sannyas. There is a story of Tridanda sannyasi. In all Upanishads, it has been clearly given the method by which a person can take renounce or sannyas by suffering cloth and dunt and door and coffin. There is a sannyas Upanishad also. In Gita also it has been written about sannyas. Who are really sannyas? But never it has been told about Babaji. So there is no Guru Parampara. Nothing anywhere written about that. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was not himself Babaji. Madhvacharya Raman, who is any of them, were not Babaji. We know that Ishwar Puripad, Madhvendra Puri were not Babaji, they were Sannyasi. After that, Sanatana Goswami was Sarup Damodar Raya Ramanand, were not sannyasis, not Babaji. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he was in Varanasi, in Kashi, Sanatana Goswami came in a beggar, Muslim beggar shape there. So much beard and very dirty clothes like Mohammedan beggars. But when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu met, he at once ran towards him and embraced him. Then he ordered to be sacred, to go take bath in Ganges and to say he came. And then Tapan Mishra, the associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, wanted to give him new cloth, but he refused it. And he told, if you want to give me cloth, then you should give me old your dhoti. And he did. And he made his baribas out of cloth and door and coffin of sannyasis. And he took himself, no fire sacrifice or anything. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did not give any mantra to him for this, nothing. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu at that time was in his red cloth. Sanatana Goswami thought that I should be very humble. I should not take the clothes of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He had so much honor for that sannyasi clothes and danda and everything. So being a humble person, he took only white dress in very small, that he is not going to take so much lamba dhoti, kurta and all other things. As he required
minimum.
Only this. To minimize, he took that case. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, it is not anywhere written that he took gopi bhav. That you are gopi, you are lalita, you are vishakha, and I am giving you 11 kinds of modes. Your name is Lalita, you are inhabitants of Barsana, your birthplace is Barsana, you are married to any Abhimanyu Gop, and your dress is this, and you are Palladasi of Radhika from today, never he gave anything. Not even anywhere written these things. Rupa Goswami, has he taken anything from anyone? Nothing. He was like ordinary. In white dress, he has taken danda and command, door and coffin are not, it is not written anywhere about Jeev Goswami. He was Jeev Goswami, not Jeev Babaji. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, his older name from Grihastha, Shyamananda Prabhu, Narottam Thakur, and Shivas, Srinivasavacha, never Babaji. Anywhere not written, and by in this line, that you are gopi and what gopi. Also, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, from to end, he was Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, householder name, Chakravarti. This is the upadhi,
title
of Vaishnava Brahmin. Also, Baldev Vidyabhushan, not Babaji. So we see that there is no word Babaji, but it was used for old persons in villages. Like someone used to tell Sanatana Goswami, oh, you are great Babaji, Bada Babaji. So not like this that anyone coming from, he has not left worldly desires, he not renounced, and he has not known all the Vaishnava established truths. He is engaged in only four things: eating, sleeping, fearing and mating. Also involved in three W's. And anyone comes at once, Babaji used to give him, oh, you are Lalita. You are Vishakha. This is the call of all evils. This is the root of all the evils. Anywhere it is not written like this. So there is no Guru Parampara of these Babajis. And that is why they tell Gaudiya Vaishnava from origin, from Brahma to Narada, Vyasa, Sukadeva Goswami, Madhvacharya and his parampara, and then Madhvendra Puri, Ishwar Puri, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Rup Sanatan, Jeev, Raghunath, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, three, Narottam Thakur, Shyamananda, and after that Krishnadas, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, Vishwanath. We are called a Guru Parampara. Someone can raise anything about Bhaktivinoda Thakur, that who was his guru? He accepted Bipin Bihari Goswami no harm, but his Siksha Guru and Bhagavat Parampara Guru was Jagannath Das Swami Narayan. Siksha Guru is not less than any Diksha Guru. Sometimes he may be more than Diksha Guru. Like we accept Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Radha and Krishna, Rupa Goswami, or Siksha Guru. Like
Krishna Das ka Viraj Goswami has accepted four, six Shiksha Guru Ji Amar. Eichai Goswami Ji is Shiksha Guru Ji Amar. So there should be no doubt about this, all these things. So sometimes Shiksha Guru may be more superior than Diksha Guru. I know, I have so much faith and belief in my Gurudev, but I know that Rupa Goswami is Guru of my Gurudev. Śrīla Bhaktivedanta Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami, though he is Jagat Guru, but he always considered Rupa Goswami. And Śrīmatī Rādhikā, he is Siksha Guru. You know, Sikhipachyamoli, this is slow.
Siksha Guru Sya Bhagavan Sikhipachyamoli.
Bilva Mangala Thakur has prayed in his book, Krishna Karanamrit. Yes, Siksha Guru is my Krishna himself, Nanda Nanda, Sikhipachyamoli, keeping black feather shear and bansi in his
hand,
in his lips. So, his guru, who was his guru? Somgiri. But he preferred his Gurudev, Siksha Guru, Krishna. He can respect his Gurudev, but he is respected more superior his Siksha Guru. So, we should not forget all these things. So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur has Guru, who was Vipin Bihari Goswami, has written in Chaitanya Charitamrita explanation. But his Siksha Guru and Bhagavat Parampara Guru was Jagannath Das Swaji. No harm. Jagannath Baba Ji has his recently Guru Parampara. Srila Prabhupada has accepted Srila Gaukrasov Das Swaji Maharaj. He was undoubtedly, he was a pure Vaishnava. He was not only, but he was Mahabhava. Can you tell that who was Guru of Haridas Thakur? No need. If any Brahma or Prahlad Maharaj is coming in the shape of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu associate, they don't need anything. They should accept without any doubt. Can you tell who was the Guru of Swarup Damodar? Who was the Guru of Shivas Pandit? Shivas Pandit was like Narad, Murari Gupta was
Hanuman.
He may be initiated from other, but Chaitanya Mahaprabhu accepted all. So there is no any, we don't know Guru, but we accept him. So we should not have any doubt about Swamiji that he has no Guru Parampara, Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. His Guru was Srila Gaukrasov Das Swaji Maharaj, you know, and his Siksha Guru who was Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He has taken all these things, all all Siddhants and Gurus from Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. If there is no Guru Parampara of no Guru of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, yet he is Vaishnava, like Haridas Thakur and others, but he has. So, there is no any doubt about this. If anyone has doubt, they will lose their bhakti and they will go to hell. All Babaji are not like that. They are very jealous, and that is why they are telling. From where it began, I don't know. Can anyone of Babaji in Vrindavan, Radha Kund, they can tell that from here it begins Babaji Vesh? They cannot tell. But if they can tell very easily, oh, Gaudiya Vaishnava has no fun. And the bogus persons, shaking like pendulum, rejected by Gaudiya Vaishnava. So, Vyabhichari.
No.
Having so much lust, reject the type Gaudiya Vasistha, they go and become Babaji. So you should be very strong in this thing. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada and Swamiji and me, we don't going to criticize them. Their rules and regulations, keeping Babaji base. But we criticize their mood. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is telling in Jaiva Dharma.
Nous avons Maharajov, c'est Zinombar de Pranam, au pied paré de l'étude, ils sont là spirituels. Ensuite, ils sont aussi le Guru, maintenant ils sont par Opal. J'ai prêché dans le monde entier. En si peu de temps, la mission de Mahaprabhu, par sa miséricorde, il dévoue dans le monde entier en lisant ses livres, vient à cette lignée, fréquente ses disciples et adopte la conscience de Krishna. Sadhu Maharaj est un véritable Guru, authentique. Par sa miséricorde, tous peuvent connaître Radha Krishna, Mahaprabhu et ses enseignements. Aujourd'hui, en Vrindavan, il y a un phénomène assez particulier. On voit qu'il y a de nombreuses personnes qu'on appelle des Babaji qui disent que Swamiji, c'est le nom que l'on donne à Prabhupada dans le Vajramat, Swami Maharaj ou Swamiji, par affection. Swamiji n'a pas une parampara authentique, ou Shabakisimanta non plus n'a pas une parampara authentique, ou son initiation n'est pas authentique. Mais seulement des gens qui sont ignorants, qui ne connaissent pas bien la philosophie ou pas les écritures, peuvent prêter oreille à de tels racontables. Comment est-ce que quelqu'un qui a prêché la conscience de Krishna en si peu de temps, avec tant de vigueur et tant de succès dans le monde entier, qui a traduit des livres authentiques, commentés, des livres comme le Chaitanya Charitamrita, le Bhagavatam, etc., pouvait être quelqu'un d'ordinaire? Ça n'a aucun sens. Et dans la lignée de Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Bhaktisiddhanta, Rupa, les saints termes de Swami, Sarvabhauta, Vairavananda, qui a pris Babaji? Ces gens-là sont des gens qui sont envieux et qui critiquent. Ils n'ont pas de gourou parampara, mais très facilement ils disent « Oh, mais les Gaudiya Vaishnava, les Gaudiya Vaishnava n'ont pas de parampara. » Mais Swami Sarvabhauta qui raconte toute sorte d'inepties qui offense la parampara. Alors, aucun Shastra, aucun Purana, aucun Upanishad, Mahabharata, Ramayana, nulle part dans les commentaires ou les écrits des Goswami ou des Acharya après eux, on trouve ce mot de Babaji. D'où est-ce que ça vient? Par contre, on voit l'ordre de Sannyas, l'ordre du renoncement est mentionné partout. Sannyas, Trilanda Sannyas, c'est mentionné dans Bhagavatam, dans l'Upanishad. C'est qu'avant expliquer comment est-ce que l'on adopte l'ordre du renoncement, le Sannyas, en prenant un danda, Bhagavesh, un vêtement extérieur. On appelle un top de sannyas et un copine. Il y a même une sannyas Upanishad. Et nulle part on parle de Babaji. Dans la Gita également, le sannyas est décrit, le sannyas authentique, nulle part on parle de Babaji. Il n'y a pas de guru parampara pour le Babaji. Mahaprabhu n'était pas le même Babaji, ni Ramananda Roy, ni Ramanuja, ni Madhvacharya, ni Ishwarapuri, ni Madhavandapuri. C'était tous des sannyasis, pas les Babaji. À Benares, lorsque Sanatana Goswami a approché Mahaprabhu, Chitapan Nisha, il était habillé comme un fakir, un mendiant musulman, avec tout sale de tout son périple dans la forêt, dans la jungle, avec une grande barbe, des vêtements très sales, tout poussiéreux. Mahaprabhu l'a étreint, il l'a envoyé se purifier au Gange et se raser. Lorsqu'il est revenu, Tapa Mishra voulait lui offrir des habits neufs. Il lui dit non, donne-moi juste un vieux dhoti qu'il a coupé, qui s'est mis autour des reins, s'est fait un copine là-dedans, et un vêtement, comme une petite chada par-dessus. Pourquoi? Parce que Mahaprabhu lui-même portait le safran. Et par humilité, Sanatana Goswami ne voulait pas imiter ou porter le même vêtement que Mahaprabhu qu'il estimait tellement. Donc, par humilité, pour être insignifiant, il a pris cet habit blanc de Babaji, pas comme une position supérieure. Oui. Simplement pour prendre une position humble. Mais il est mentionné nulle part qu'il a adopté quelqu'un, que Mahaprabhu lui donnait un mantra, Gopi Bhav, Ekadasa Bhav, les 11 caractéristiques, tu es Lalita, tu es Amitabha Varshana, tu es marié avec Abhimanyu, Gopa, tu as telle couleur, telle seva, telle kunja, tel âge, etc. Nulle part ça mentionne ces choses-là. Jiva Goswami n'était pas Jiva Babaji, c'était Jiva Goswami. Nulle part on ne mentionnait pas Babaji. Tout notre chandra en scripture, Jiva Skandraj Goswami, pas Babaji. Srinivas Acharya, Narottam Das Thakur, Shyamananda Goswami, aucune mention de Babaji Parampara. Jusqu'à Baladevi Vidyabhushan, nulle part il est mentionné une chose pareille. Et Shyamananda Chakravarti Thakur, jusqu'à la fin de ses jours, il est toujours Chakravarti, qui est le nom de Grihastha, une famille de Grihastha Brahmana. Nulle part il est mentionné Babaji. Ce mot Babaji, on l'utilise dans les villages pour dire à une vieille personne, oh Baba, oh c'est un grand Babaji. Donc J est utilisé comme respect. Ce n'est jamais été un titre, et nulle part il y a une institution.
Baba means father.
Baba veut dire une vieille personne, père ou grand-père. Donc, c'est un mot simplement utilisé dans les villages. Nulle part donc il y a une mention que quelqu'un peut venir, qui n'est pas libéré des visions matérielles, des propensions animales, et qu'on va lui révéler, voilà, tu t'appelles, tu es tel gopi, et etc. Et tu as telle couleur, là ton service. Alors qu'il sait, Maharaj disait qu'il ne sait même pas comment se nettoyer après avoir été aux toilettes. On lui révèle qui est le monde spirituel, son identité éternelle. Notre parampara commence par Brahma, elle descend jusqu'à Mahaprabhu, les Goswami, Rupa Goswami, ensuite toute notre parampara est mentionnée, jusqu'à Bhaktivinoda Thakur. On n'a aucun doute là-dessus. Il faut dissiper tous ces doutes qui n'ont aucun lieu d'être. Bhaktivinoda Thakur a pris l'initiation de qui? Bipindari Goswami. Pas de problème, laissons Sikshaguru Vitalanadas Babaji Maharaj, Paramahamsa Maharaj. Il y a une parampara, il y a une Bhagavad parampara. Et dans notre lignée, on peut voir que la Siksha parampara est bien plus importante encore.
Guru parampara is included in Bhagavad parampara. Without Bhagavad parampara, Guru parampara is not complete. Not complete.
On dit que dans la Bhagavad parampara, ce Guru parampara est inclus. S'il n'y a pas cette Bhagavad parampara, la parampara juste des gurus n'a pas lieu d'être, ou elle est inutile, elle n'est pas complète. Donc, dans notre lignée, cette Bhagavad Parampara passe le plus souvent par le Siksha Guru. Krishna Das Kaviraj, lui, qui est son maître spirituel? Qui peut dire qu'il est son guru? Mais on sait qu'il a accepté les six Goswami comme son Siksha Guru. Moi-même, j'ai tellement de foi dans mon propre maître spirituel, mais je sais que Rupa Goswami est le guru du guru du guru de mon guru. Prabhupada Nakisimata Sarasvati Thakur, lui aussi, c'est une parampara tout à fait authentique, il n'y a aucun doute là-dessus, on doit dissiper tous ces doutes. Il a pris l'initiation de Gauri Krishna Babaji Maharaj, qui était un pur dévot sans aucun doute. Qui était le gourou d'Haridas Thakur? Qui était le gourou de Sarvodaya Maharaj? Sarvodaya Goswami? Qui était le gourou de Srinivas Pandit? Ça, ce sont des associés éternels de Krishna, comme Narada Muni, ou Hanuman, ou Brahma, ou Prahlad Maharaj, qui viennent jouer le rôle de compagnon éternel, de compagnon de Mahaprabhu, et donc ils n'ont pas besoin de prendre la main spirituelle. Donc le nom de ces gourous n'est même pas mentionné. Il n'y a aucun doute que Swami Maharaj est une parampara authentique. Bhaktisiddhanta et son Diksha Guru, comme Siksha Guru, il a accepté la Vaikuntha Thakur. Quand on lit ses livres, on voit que tout son Siddhanta, tout l'état de vin, tout ça, son tempérament, mon dévotionnel, vient et est inspiré de Vaikuntha Thakur. Vaikuntha Thakur a une parampara, Bhagavad parampara complètement authentique. Si quelqu'un a des doutes à ce sujet-là et maintient et continue à entretenir ses doutes, simplement il va perdre sa bhakti et ensuite se dégrader vers l'enfer. Les Babaji sont simplement envieux, ils sont antagonistes, ils ne peuvent pas dire d'où a commencé leur pratique de Babaji Vesh, mais ils sont très, très forts pour dire « Oh, les Gaudiens, la Gaudiya Mata, ils n'ont pas de parents. » Et parmi eux, et les gens qui vont les voir, tellement de gens sans scrupules, sans caractère, tant de débauchés, qui vont les voir, et qui les approche. Donc, ne critique pas Maharaj dit, ni lui-même, ni son propre gourou, ni la Kisanta ne critiquait le fait qu'ils prennent la Babaji Vesh. Mais c'est leur tempérament et leur attitude qui les critiquent.
We don't criticize our Bhaktivinoda Thakur, and anyone has not criticized about that Vesh taking door and coffin. Like accepting that we are falling gopis. We criticize our Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Srila Prabhupada, and all group person, all has criticized that a newcomer person who comes, he does not know anything, something. Quarreling with his wife or his wife has divorced them, to his husband. And he has no means to support his life. And anyhow he comes and sees that, oh, in this life, if I will take Babaji Vesh, then everything will be solved. Also, I may have 2, 3, 4, 5 ladies also,
widows
also, no harm, and we will then be equipped with all the things which is necessary for worldly life. Even there no any symptom of renounce. There's too much attached with worldly things. Even then they are so lusty. There is no established truth that no don't know anything about this. They don't know what is bhakti, what is who is Krishna, what is bhakti rush. They don't know even which are gopis. Nothing, anything. Also, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, I am reading from Bhakti Vinod Thakur. They have no Shuddha pure bhakti to Krishna. They are always engaged in asat sangha, vishayi sangha, association of self-gratifications, persons, five persons. They are also having some irsha, dvesh,
envy and malice.
But even if you go to Radha Kunda and Vrindavan, they will take only 5 anas paisa. 5 ana means?
Only quarter rupees.
25 paisa. This value is nothing. They will take and they will think that, oh, we are making in him Guru Pan. And at once, without delay, because they will think that he will go to other Babaji and he will make decision. So, he will at once give him, they will give up their hairs and he will give them door and copying. And thus, at once Gopi moved that you are Lalita, you are Rup Manjari, you are Manjari. This is not correct method. First, we should try to obey all the rules and regulations being in Grihastha. Then be detached from worldly affairs totally. And coming in Vaishnava Sadhu Sangha, then Shraddha, and then with Shraddha again Sadhu Sangha. And then after Sadhu Sangha, he will understand the need of Sadguru. And he will inquire and khojega.
Search.
He will search a very good, qualified Guru. And then he will take initiation. And he will take Shiksha from him. Shiksha means teachings and instruction. And he will start Gurudev in a beautiful friends, like friends. Vishambena Gurau Seva. And he will offer totally to Gurudev. And here so many days, so many years. And he will be qualified in all this basic and all kinds of bhakti, siddhanta, established truth. He will know bhakti, sandarbha, and all Srimad Bhagavatam. And then he will qualify and he will come to the stage of nishtha. And after completing the course of nishtha, when he will be matured in nishtha, then ruchi will come automatically. When ruchi will come, it will come first on bhajan, that is chanting, remember, and all these things. So it is also of two kinds. Then asakti will come. It is also of two kinds. First it will come, asakti in chanting, remembering, and it will be, now again, it will turn into asakti towards bhajaniya, that is Krishna and Radha, conjugal, or Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And then he will be qualified to take these ways, door and coffin. And mood of 11 moods can come at that stage, and Guru will help him in taking a path of what is your Siddha De. In that very stage, not before this. If before this anyone giving him Siddha De, then he will go to hell. Certainly. So in this stage, Gurudev tells him that you are so and so. Your name, Siddha De, Nami. Not outwardly because anything like Sarva Damodar and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told all these things to Radha Kund when he came, and he was so much learned in all kinds of bhakti. And you know how he was renounced? He used to take the rotten remnants of Jagannath, even taken by him.
Not taken by
Rejected by
him. Rejected by him. So we should be qualified like this, and then we will be qualified for Ekadas and 11 lines of moves. And then our Siddha De, we can, in by Siddha De, we can serve 24 hours. This is real method, and this is Siddha Pranali. Not that anyone is coming, and what I told, not qualified, just today coming. And oh, you are Lalita Gopi, you are this and that, you are the daughter of Vishabhan Maharaj, and you have been married to Javat, and your place is in Radha Kunda, and you are so beautiful, wow, Mohini, and you are Gauri, and he has so much it. What? His hair, beard, and giving up all this, he becomes in the shape of Gopi, taking
nose ring,
making choti here, wearing the ornaments of white ladies, some nupur, mental battery in the fields, and the baby becomes. We don't follow these things. And in these guys, they will be with so many widows in India, and they will end child. So this is not real method and Siddha Pranali. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur is giving this. And Swarup Goswami has given this Siddha Pranali. In Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in Chaitanya Chaitanya, they have given this bona fide and Siddha Pranali. But we cannot follow in this stage. We'll have to remember all our anatsa, aparadhan. That should be asakti, that should be very, very attachment in chanting, remembering, and all kinds of offenses have gone away. And then Gurudev will kindly, mercifully, he will accept him as his guru, as his disciple, and he will give the paricha,
identification
of his. We have all, but Siddha De. But it is hidden by Maya. Indeed, this material body and my body. But it is there. But who will know? If after you are having Purushbhav means?
Male mood.
But hiding this, being a female, and you will associate with other ladies, then what will be? So he must go to hell, and they are going. There is no Guru Parampara of these Vaishnavas. So, we should try to be very bona fide in this and very strong. Have they written any book? Or Babaji? Never. They don't know what is all these things. Once our Guruji was in Vrindavan with 400 persons, pilgrims, and he was doing Braj Mandal Parikrama. He invited so many Babaji. About 400 Babaji came, gathered here. And he was giving them feast. He asked all the Babajis, what is the aim and object of your sadhana and bhajan? They told that we want to be liberated and we want to mix in Brahma and we want to become Brahma. Even they don't know Mayavad, what is Mayavad? Against bhakti. Then Guru Maharaj was very, very mad.
Angry.
And he began to cut their all kinds of arguments. So, we should know that our Guru Parampara is bona fide. Don't associate with Babaji. You can associate if you are so strong like us. I used to go to in Parikrama to Dadakunda and challenge them that if you are learned, you know anything, then come and discuss all these things. If I will be defeated, I will be Babaji. And I will be your disciple. Otherwise, you should be my disciple. Never anyone can come and answer. So you should think that we are in very good parampara, bona fide parampara. Bhakti Vinod Thakur is telling that you should also have you read Jaiva Dharma? You should try to read it very carefully. There were two persons, Vijay Kumar and Prajnanand. They at first accepted Guru at Vaishnavadas in Mayapur and they learned all kinds of bhaktis and everything. 64 kinds of bhaktis and everything. They were now expert in bhakti. And then their Guru sent them to Jagannath Puri. And they met with Gopal Guru. And that they learned what is bhakti and what is bhakti ras. Who is Krishna? Who is Srimati Radhika and who are gopis? And what is, how a bhakti can be turned into bhakti ras? They became so perfect in all these things. And after that, Gopal Guru gave them these things, Ekadash books, and the door and coffin. This is the thing, this is Siddha Pranali. What Babaji are doing now, they are doing nonsense, not in Siddha Pranali. They should first learn Tivnadapi Sunitena, Tarorapi Sahishnuna, Amarina, Manadena, Kirtaniya, Sadahari. They should be like this. But you know, Thakur is telling here. We see nowadays, have you Jaiva Dharma? He is telling that now we can see in Vrindavan that they have left their homes in very childhood. And they come to Vrindavan and Radhakunda having so much lust in their heart, knowing nothing about bhakti, they are ignorant of all these things. They come to Vrindavan Radhakund and then they take this Siddha Pranali. Not Siddha, Asiddha Pranali. What is Asiddha?
Imperfect, imperfect system.
Babaji wish. And become Babaji. And if you tell who are you, what is your name? Oh, my name is Lalita Devi.
Oh,
you are They try to hide their female organs. male organs. And they try to show that they are gopi.
They dress themselves like...
Whether they are not, but in beginning, they don't know how to wash their hands and tool and other things and become Lalita Devi. Then they will certainly want any Krishna. Then they search so many gopis and thus they go to heaven. This is not Siddha Pranali Bhakti Vinod Thakur is telling. So they must be qualified. A guru should think first to whom they are going to make, give this Babaji vesh, door and coping. Whether he is qualified for this or not, they should see whether they are attend Sham, Dham and Brahmamood or not. Sham, Dham means?
Self-control.
Controlling the mind, controlling the senses.
Controlling mind and this body, all senses also. They are given up money, attraction or not. They are given up the lalsa of jiva.
Attachment of the tongue.
Attachment of tongue. What is that? To take very bitter things, to take cigarette, to take wine, to take
ganja.
Not all these things, but very attracted to ganja and bhang and drugs. This will lead certainly to a hell. Everywhere. In Upadeshamritam, Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Srila Rupa Goswami has told that someone thinks like an Indian, some yogis, that it will help to take ganja, bhang, cigarette. They don't take cigarette, but ganja and bhang. And they think that now we are absorbed in Krishna prema. But they are so foolish, they cannot imagine that they are going to be mad. Like dogs and hawks. Anywhere in the books of Rupa Goswami or Chaitanya Charitamrita or in the books of Jiva Goswami, even in Srimad Bhagavata, it has been told. But Eshro, Dyutam, Panam, Istriyam, Suna, Jatra, Chaturvida. We should try to avoid first coming to Gurudev or before coming to Gurudev in Grihastha life. We should control four things. Basic principles. These are not bhakti, but yet they will take us in the door of bhakti. To what?
Dutam,
panam. Dutam. Dutam means?
Gambling.
Gambling.
Panam?
Drinking.
You can read. Panam?
Bing.
Cigarette. Even cigarette. Vidi. Tambaku. And the masala of tambaku.
Tobacco.
Tobacco and its supporters. Like? Often, ganja is given in them.
Marijuana.
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 And all other things. They will bring lust surely in a day or two or in. Their intelligence will go away. They will go out of bhakti route. That is surely. So all Srimad Bhagavatam, in the first canto, Srila Sukadeva Goswami prohibited for all kinds of devotees. Don't touch all these things. So don't think that they will add something helpful like some things like this. In Indian, some Vaishnava of Ramanuj, Ramanandi, they took, they opium, ganja, bhang, and chilam, you know, very big, big chilam.
Water pipe.
And flame of their water pipe goes so high. And then he is considered to be a very high class of that becomes naked and quarrel with Sarsha. Very dangerous tamashi. So we should be avoid. This is maha maha.
Various offense.
Poison. So we should try to give up all these things. And then, if you have any desire for making money for sense gratification, then he should not be given that Babaji wish. What I told. Bhakti Vinod Thakur is telling, Rup Goswami is telling in Upadeshamritam, Jivabe. If anyone giving in this state, then it is not Siddha Pranali. It is the Pranali way to go to hell. So we should try to be very much strong in our Guru Parampara. Our Guru Parampara is right, but their Guru Parampara is not right. Artificial. Only from 100 years their process, the Siddha Pranali has come. But our real Siddha Pranali has come from Vedas, Upanishadas, in Rishi, in that Shankar. He is giving Siddha Pranali to Chatushan, and Narada is giving to another. This is Siddha Pranali. We accept this. But in a right way, in a right process and in the right time. If any is doing, Bhakti Vinod Thakur is telling that.
Maharaj dit, il y a une critique, on parle de l'habit, le fait de prendre le renoncement, prendre un bain et un copier, mais ce qu'il dit, le fait qu'il dise qu'il suit dans les traces des gopis. Ce que nous critiquons, ce qui a été critiqué par nos acharyas, c'est le fait que si quelqu'un a un mariage malheureux, il se crée avec son épouse, et il la quitte, il se fâche, et il se dit, si je prends cet habit de Balaji, tout le monde va me respecter, je pourrais vivre paisiblement sans travailler et sans aucun souci pour le maintenir. Et ensuite, il va récolter 3 ou 4 veuves avec qui il va avoir des enfants, etc. Cette attitude-là a été critiquée. Oui. Le fait que quelqu'un n'a pas de connaissance de Tadva, je ne sais pas ce que c'est que la Bhakti, ni Bhakti Rasa, il a encore plein de désirs matériels. Que quelqu'un lui donne, qu'il prenne cet avis de Babaji, quelqu'un lui donne cet avis de Babaji, c'est ça que nous critiquons. Pas le fait qu'il ait cet avis de Babaji ou qu'il parle des gourous. Bhakti Thakur, dans son livre, Jivadharma dit, ils n'ont pas de pure Bhakti, ils n'ont pas de satsanga, de bonne association, mais ils sont toujours en train de fréquenter les gens qui sont attachés au plaisir des sens, ils sont encore remplis d'envie et de malice, et pour quelques paysans, si quelqu'un vient et leur demande de leur donner Babaji, de peur qu'ils aillent voir quelqu'un d'autre, donc il manque un disciple, ils vont lui donner tout de suite Babaji. Ouais. À n'importe qui, ils vont initier quelqu'un tout de suite, et lui révéler, voilà, tu es Lalita Saki, tu es Rupa Manjari, tu es tel Manjari, sans aucune qualification du candidat qui les approche. Normalement, on doit suivre un processus. Si quelqu'un est Grihastha, il doit suivre les règles Grihastha Ashram, se purifie totalement, et ensuite, petit à petit, il va pouvoir renoncer. Il y a un processus qu'on doit suivre pas à pas, commençant par Shraddha, on appelle la foi, vraiment un désir de renoncement, un désir d'élévation spirituelle, ensuite approcher un maître authentique, fréquenter les sadhus, recevoir l'initiation, pratiquer vraiment la bhakti. Et si quelqu'un sert ainsi son maître spirituel avec affection, ce maître spirituel rempli d'affection pour lui, et après une pratique telle pendant des années et des années de purification, graduellement on va arriver à s'approcher de l'anartha, arriver à Nishta. Une fois qu'on est fermement établi sur cette plateforme, automatiquement, Ruchi, le véritable goût pour la vie spirituelle, va se développer automatiquement. Maharaj dit ce goût est développé techniquement en deux parties, un goût pour un attrait pour Krishna et un attrait pour les choses contraires à Krishna. De la valeur à Sakti, d'abord l'attache la Sakti à Bhajan, l'activité dévotionnelle, et ensuite à Bhajaniya, Krishna lui-même qui est le but du Bhajan. Mais si quelqu'un n'a pas ces qualifications, il ne peut pas prendre l'habit de renoncement. Quelqu'un qui est arrivé à ce niveau-là, la Sakti, il peut prendre l'habit de renoncement. Il est qualifié. À ce niveau-là, lorsqu'il va rentrer dans Bhava, il peut recevoir son sidhavya, son corps spirituel. Le maître spirituel va lui révéler à ce niveau-là de qualification qui il est éternellement, quelle est sa véritable identité éternelle. Si on lui révèle avant, c'est simplement l'ouvrir la porte vers l'enfer. Et il y a quelqu'un qui a ce niveau d'avancement spirituel, c'est pas qu'il prend une position, qu'il s'habille différemment, qu'il adopte des signes externes. C'est toute une affaire interne, pas quelque chose qu'on va montrer extérieurement. On voit par exemple Raghunath Das Goswami, lorsqu'il était à Puri, il était tellement renoncé, il allait retenir les restes de prachat, que même les vaches ne voulaient plus manger. Et ça, c'est la vraie méthode. Quand quelqu'un aura ce renoncement, comment Raghunath Das Goswami, alors peut-être il peut approcher cette qualification pour prendre la vie de renoncement. Et ça, c'est le vrai Siddha Pranali, la vraie révélation pour atteindre la perfection. C'est pas qu'on donne ça à un nouveau qui n'a pas de qualification. Oh, tu es l'Alita, tu es la fille de Rishabhanu Maharaj, il a ses moustaches, Maharaj, il a une moustache et une barbe, mais alors il va les raser pour essayer de cacher tous les signes de virilité, se mettre une bague au nez, se mettre des boucles d'oreilles, se mettre des clochettes aux pieds, s'habiller comme une gopi. Ça, c'est pas comme ça que ça marche. D'abord, il doit y avoir. Et ensuite, il va approcher des veuves, et avec ces veuves, la soi-disant gopi va avoir des enfants. C'est pas comme ça qu'on a fait le processus. Il doit y avoir une qualification graduelle. Il doit y avoir, on doit se débarrasser de l'anatta. L'anatta niriti doit être là, doit avoir pris place, et libérer de l'attachement, et ensuite s'attacher à Krishna et à la bhakti. Ensuite, le gourou va révéler quelle est notre qualification éternelle, quelle est notre siddhadeha. Maharaji, nous avons tous un siddhadeha. Tous les jivas ont un corps spirituel éternel. Mais maintenant, il est recouvert par l'illusion, recouvert par Maya. Si quelqu'un qui est encore identifié en tant qu'homme, extérieur, artificiellement, il veut s'identifier comme une manjari, comme une gopi, qu'est-ce qu'il va faire? Il va fréquenter les autres, des femmes, et qu'est-ce qui va lui arriver? Il va juste glisser vers l'enfer, c'est tout. Les Babaji, qu'est-ce qu'ils ont écrit comme livre authentique? Citez-moi un seul livre écrit par un Babaji. Ils n'ont pas de livre. Hein? La plupart d'entre eux sont très ignorants du Siddhanta ou des Tattva. Il y a une anecdote que raconte Maharaj, qui était un jour à Radhakund, son maître spirituel, Bhakti Pranam Vishnu Maharaj, et 400 disciples, ils étaient Rajananda Parikram. Et ils ont invité pour le prachat 400 Babaji de Radhakund. Et son gourou leur a demandé, mais quel est le but en fait de votre sadhana, de votre bhajan? Qu'est-ce que vous recherchez? Et ils lui ont dit, en fait, ce qu'on veut, c'est la libération et devenir un avec Brahma, avec l'absolu. Et là, son maître spirituel s'est vraiment fâché de voir qu'il se posait comme des Vaishnavas, mais en fait, il ne se connaissait même pas. Il ne savait même pas que Mayavad et la Bhakti sont complètement antagonistes. Donc, il a défait tous les arguments. Il dit, chaque fois qu'on va à Radhakund pour le Rajaman Parikram, on défie ouvertement tous les Babaji de venir discuter, si quelqu'un peut venir débattre avec nous, discuter, donner des arguments chastriques. Babaji, s'ils réussissent à me vaincre philosophiquement, je vais devenir moi-même un Babaji. Et sinon, c'est lui qui va devenir mes disciples. Jusqu'à ce jour, aucun d'entre eux n'a osé venir parler philosophiquement. Parce que la plupart d'entre eux n'ont pas de base philosophique. C'est très, très sentimental. Notre parampara est complètement authentique, elle est extrêmement ancienne, elle est pure, et notre parampara est pratiquement inexistante. Dans le Jivarama de Bhaktivinoda Thakur, on parle également de Baba Jivesh, mais de façon authentique. Il a expliqué qu'il y a deux personnages dans ce livre, Vijay Kumar et Vrajanath, qui sont venus disciples de Vaishnava Das. Ensuite, lorsqu'ils sont devenus experts, guidés par lui dans les 64 branches de la Bhakti, ils ont été envoyés par leur gourou à Puri voir Gopalpur, Goswami. Et de lui, ils ont appris qu'est-ce que c'est que la Bhakti, qu'est-ce que c'est que Bhakti Rasa, comment la Bhakti se transforme, on passe de Bhakti à Bhakti Rasa. Qu'est-ce que c'est, qui est Krishna véritablement, qui sont les gopis, qui est Radharani. Après cela, ils ont reçu de lui les Kadasabhavs, ces 11 identifications, ces 11 caractéristiques du corps spirituel, pas avant. Et ça, c'est le véritable Siddha Pranali. Et les Babaji ne suivent pas cela. Ils donnent artificiellement à des gens sans qualification cette identité éternelle avec cette caractéristique. Et Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur disait, en fait, le véritable Shila Pranamis, il est basé sur Trina Api Sunichina. Dans le Shila Charitamrita, c'est ce que Mahaprabhu a énoncé. Il faut chanter avec ce moule. Ensuite, on peut atteindre la perfection. Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur, Maharaj, nous voyons à Vrindavan des gens qui quittent leur foyer prématurément. Ils viennent à Radhakul, ils sont remplis encore de concupiscence. Ils sont complètement ignorants de la bhakti et ils reçoivent Siddha, ou plutôt Asiddha Pranami. Non pas Siddha Pranami, mais Asiddha Pranami. Le processus, non pas pour arriver à la perfection, mais pour arriver vers le bas, vers l'imperfection. Et ensuite, on leur demande comment tu t'appelles. Oh, moi je suis Lalita Devi. Oh, tu es Lalita. Et ils cachent leur signe de virilité, ils s'identifient comme des gopis, mais après, qu'est-ce qu'ils font? Ils vont chercher un Krishna, ils vont chercher ensuite des gopis, ils vont tous aller en enfer. Donc le candidat doit être qualifié, c'est le point sur lequel Maharaj insiste. Non pas critiquer les Babaji ou la pratique de Babaji Vesh, de. Et le point, c'est que le candidat doit être qualifié. Le gourou doit voir, avant de donner l'ordonnancement, est-ce qu'il a des qualifications, hein? Est-ce qu'il a développé le sama, dhamma, le contrôle des sens, la maîtrise du mental? Est-ce qu'il est encore attiré par l'argent ou pas? Est-ce qu'il est encore attaché au plaisir de la langue? Est-ce qu'il est encore attaché à toutes sortes de goûts, à toutes sortes d'intoxications? Beaucoup de sadhus en Inde prétendent que si on fume de la ganja, par exemple, on prend en sorte de cette intoxicant, ça va améliorer ou permettre de mieux faire son bhajan. Mais dans l'Upadeshamrita, Rupa Goswami et Bhagavata Thakur, qui l'a également commenté, mettent tous en garde contre ça. Souvent en Inde, on voit des yogis qui prennent du bang ou de la ganja en prétendant que ça va aider à la vie spirituelle. Après, ils prétendent qu'ils sont absorbés dans le Krishna Prem. Ils ne savent pas qu'en fait, ça va leur faire perdre la raison et que ça va les amener simplement au niveau des animaux. Dans le Bhagavata, dans le premier chant, il y a cette instruction de Shri Goswami, Dyutak Panam Sliakshuna. On doit s'approcher de ces quatre principes de la vie de pécheresse. Avant même de devenir au maître spirituel, on devrait être avant déjà renoncé à ces choses-là, ces quatre principes. Il ne faut pas avoir fait la bhakti, mais ils aident à atteindre la porte même de la bhakti. Dyutak, c'est la première chose, c'est le jeu de hasard. Ensuite, panade, l'intoxicant. En Inde, on voit souvent, par Ajapetsa, des soi-disant sadhus qui appartiennent à une déviation de la Ramacha Sampradaya, qu'on appelle les Ramanandi. Et eux, ils sont habillés comme des Shivaïs, ils font des grands Shilams, parce qu'ils tirent sur leur Shilam, leur tout par haut, les flammes, elles montent pratiquement à un mètre, et oh, ça c'est un grand Vaishnava. Et ils sont souvent armés avec des haches ou des tridents, ils se querellent entre eux, ils sont des gens très tamasiques et très dangereux en fait. Également, le gourou doit voir si le désir de gagner de l'argent pour le plaisir de sens est encore dans le candidat, il ne doit pas lui accorder le vêtement de renoncement. Si quelqu'un lui donne à ce niveau-là, ce n'est pas un Sila Pranali, mais c'est un ticket en fait vers l'enfer. Donc on doit avoir une foi totale dans le Guru Parampara, qui est complètement authentique, et celle de ses Babaji, ou soi-disant Babaji, elle a à peine 100 ans, c'est une pratique complètement nouvelle. Et dans tous les Védas, on voit les choses faites de façon authentique. Dans le Véda, on raconte que Shankar, Shiva, a accordé Sila Pranali au Chatushana, aux quatre Kumaras. Également Brahma a accordé Sila Pranali à Narada. Mais c'est fait de façon authentique, c'est fait dans les normes, de façon correcte, pas de façon prématurée.
Some in Vrindavan, they are good. Like this, that Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati has no Siddha Pranayama, no Guru Pranayama. Bhakti Guru Thakur, likewise, no Guru. This should seem this very deeply and carefully that who was the Guru of Parikshit Maharaj? Can tell? We know that he may be in worldly Guru. He could have been any, like a
family guru,
like a
priest.
Sunday leader or others. But he heard Srimad Bhagavat from bona fide Vaishnava Sukadeva Goswami, renounced, detached from worldly desires, quite free. And Sukadeva Goswami has been given everything by his father and Guru Srila Vyasadeva. He heard it, Srila Srimad Bhagavat. And as a result, by hearing only Srimad Bhagavatam, even not practicing, he went direct to Golok Vrindavan. And Bhaktivinoda Srila Sanatana Goswami has told that it came in the shape of any gopi to serve conjugal. This is the process. There are two processes. Śrīla Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupāda Śrīla Bhaktivedanta Saraswati. There are bona fide disciples of Gaurakishore Dasa Bhaji Maharaj and his guru. Someone tells that, where is Siddha Pranali? Has he not heard all these things from his Siksha Guru and father Śrīla Bhaktivinoda Thakur? Like Parikshit Maharaj heard everything from Sukadeva Goswami. So there are two processes. One process, if he is qualified in all these things, like Vijay Kumar in Jaiva Dharma, or Srimad Bhagavatam Parikshit Maharaj is qualified, then he can minimize his graces and he can take himself door or coffin. No harm. Like Ramanuj took initiation from his guru. Ramanuj. He took initiation from his a guru of low caste, but he was disciple of Yamunacharya. He was not Mayavadi. He took Manish, then he wanted to take renounce order from his Gurudev Yamunacharya. When he reached to Rangam, he saw that his guru has left world and his material body was coming. He saw that his three fingers are like this. Why? He asked from all other disciples of Yamunacharya. They could not answer. Then he promised, I will take sannyas here from him.
Just now,
I am taking. And he too. And he, his one finger came like this. And then he promised that I will make a
commentary
on Vedanta to Ken. And then he promised that I will preach Sutyor Bhakti and I will write so many Bhakti books. Then he accepted Yamunacharya like his guru. He thought that my Gurudev never died. He is eternal. It is an illusory maya that a body is seen that he is dead. But Guru, bona fide Guru, qualified Guru, never dies. So you think that your Prabhupada, that is Bhaktivedanta Swami, had never died. Srila Prabhupada has Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati never died. Any of the Shatli Guru who was qualified, they will never die. I think that you will also not die, you will change your body like this. You are eternal. So, Ramanuj took sannyas there, his door, coffin and dung, after his departure from this world. Why Prabhupada cannot take
renounce order
from Gaurakishore Dasa Maharaj, eternal, but he was now, he has been
disappeared
at that time. Why he cannot take? And he took Ekadash modes, this 11 modes. Siddha Deh, Siddha Pranali, from Siddha Bhakti Vinoda Thakur. It is not wrong. It is in line of Guru Parampara. Anyone cannot deny. If we can deny Sukadeva Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, Rupa Goswami, Vyasadeva, Ramanuja, Madhya, then we can deny Siddha. He was so cold. He was Jagat Guru. He has brought a very revolution in bhakti cult. He has reformed all these things. So he is certainly in Guru Parampara. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur took everything from Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, Ekadas Mutas, and that is why he has written in this. This is Srila Bhaktivinoda. But being so much qualified, being free from all kinds of anartha and everything, then it will come automatic from upper side. It will descend in the heart of pure devotees, in the stage of bhav. So before taking this bhav coming, and you are going to imitate, I am gopi, I am siddha pranali, in siddha pranali, and you will see that his Gurudev is making so much lust with others, devotees. Family, female devotees. So we should not be bewildered in these things. I know so many, those who left Swamiji, Bhaktivedanta Swamiji, and went to Babaji, and they again returned to their lust, and they took so many Mataji here and there, and they left everything. Now they are drinking, making merry, and they are taking drugs and all things. Someone has died, they have suicided themselves, I know all. And in this line, 54 years, serving all the men disciples of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, and associating with all. So I know many, so many things that so many devotees that don't know all these things. So you must be very strong that Swamiji has Guru Parampara, Srila Prabhupada, Srila Bhakti, Siddhanta Saraswati, Bhaktivinoda Thakur has real Guru Parampara. You should not be bewildered. If you bewildered, you will have to take your bad fruits.
À Vrindavan, certains arguments que Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati n'a pas reçu de Srila Pranali. Il n'a pas une parole correcte. Et pareil pour Bhaktisiddhanta
Saraswati. Only Shastra reading will not do anything. Never. You are reading Shastra, you are reading Satsang Dharma, and you are learning Sanskrit, Anuswar and Visarga. It will not do. Nowadays, there is going on a line like this. Padhya suniya lok sab galo chare khare in Chaitanya Chaitamrita, in Chaitanya Bhagavata it has been written. You know that how learned was Keshav Kashmiri, but he was not touched of bhakti at all. He was defeated at once by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told that. The reading of Shastra, that can tell us to give up Krishna bhakti practice. You should now give up all this, you should give up every all these things. And try to practice bhakti yoga, offer yourself in the lotus feet of your Gurudev, Krishna and Radha and Nityananda Prabhu and Sri. Then bhakti will come descend in your heart. Only learning will not do. You are qualified in Anuswar, Visarga, Sanskrita. You are reading all these things. It will not be. Unless you have mercy of your Gurudev. Mercy of Krishna and Nityananda Prabhu, Baldev Prabhu. So you should go in properly. Don't follow that. Only learning of Sanskrit will not do anything. It will make us like a Gnostic, atheist. So, nowadays, going on this. So we should be very careful for this. We should know, also understand very strongly that a man who has told us all the bhaktis to us. He has given many, so many instructions. And he has made us from Bahirmukh to Antarmukh.
Backward to inward.
the pain from what of Krishna, becoming inspired to become Krishna conscious, is that all?
How we can be without Guru Parampara? It may be in some cases that to whom we have taken initiation and he is not perfect, but he is still Vaishnava. If he is not Vaishnava, you can give up him. But if he is Vaishnava, he is Madhyam Adhikari, and he is practically really in the line of his Gurudev and Guru Parampara, he should not be abhorrent. Never. You should tell him very politely that, Gurudev, can I go to Jiva Goswami to learn all these things? Oh, Guru will be happy. Oh, yes, at once he should go. And Shyamananda Prabhu Narottam Thakur and
Srinivasacharya
did at once. This is not for. If my Gurudev, chanting I am remembering well, but he is not perfect in Shastra Siddhanta, so much, then he can permit you happily to go to him. You can go to Puri Maharaj, you can go to Siddhar Maharaj, you can go to this person, you will like him. So this is not right. But he does not know, he has no Siddha Pranali, and he does not know all these things. He cannot be Gopi Bhav, and so we should reject. It is very deep, deep. Often, we should try to be careful, very. Nowadays this thought is going on.